I'm a Christian, so I gotta say what needs to be said. First, I was in church today, and there was a bunch of black Democrat politicians in there. I'm talking Stephen Holford, right? Lawrence Weekly. I'm gonna go ahead and name them, right? I'm here in Nevada. I'm gonna go ahead and name them, right? I can't think of the other guy's name, but it's on the tip of my tongue. I want to name him because I'm burning inside of upset because the black pastors have failed us. Our black leaders have failed us. The black politicians, it's an election year if y'all didn't know. So Stephen Holford is in there, oh, playing nice, oh, shaking hands, kissing babies, right? Oh, hey, how you doing, right? Step outside, Steve. Step outside. Look at our communities, right? Step outside, Steve. Look at the community that you represent. It's poor. It's poverty. It's crime. And these idiots, this November, trust me, gonna go vote for Steve again. Gonna go vote for Lawrence again. Right? Gonna go vote for the other black politicians again. Right? As we always do. And we're gonna see no change as we always have seen. Y'all seen the black lady be elected to mayor in San Francisco? My cousin gonna call and text me. Oh man, hey man, I think she gonna make some change. I'm like, she a Democrat, right? There's not gonna be no change. The reason there's not gonna be no change is because Democrats have ran the city for the last 60, 70 years. So how all of a sudden, because they change it from a woman to a man, they still have the same ideals? The problem is that their thinking is the same. You have to put someone in there who have different thinking. Do you see that America has changed because we have President Trump? We have someone in there with different thinking, someone who thinks different. Duh. Like, it's killing me. But these black politicians, but specifically, I want to talk about the black pastor. And I love my pastor. I don't want y'all to think I'm disrespecting. But I have to say this because I'm starting to realize why we are losing the young people. He said today in church, the reason losing the young people, one of the reasons is he said that we can't relate to them, right? He said that we can't relate to them. He said that we're trying to relate to them, but we can't relate to them. They want to wear a hat to church, whatever, whatnot, but we can't relate to them. But he said he know a pastor who told the straight truth to his church and lost his whole church. So that's why he said he the type of pastor that he want to make sure he can always relate to the people. See, that's where I'm going to tell you where y'all went wrong at, Pastor. You losing the young people not because you can't relate to them, but because you're not telling them the truth. He looking at his grandma. He looking at his mom. He looking at his dad. They all went to your church and they're poor and they're living in poverty and they have nothing to show for it. And he looking at them and he's saying, why in the hell should I go to that pastor when my mom went there for 20 years and she has nothing to show for it? The reason why the young people are not coming to the church is because they can Google. They have the information age. They can Google and say, why in the hell should I give my money to the pastor when we have had no salvation? That's the reason why the young people are not in the church, Pastor. Not because you can't relate to them. They don't need you to wear a hat or play hip hop. They need the truth. They need Jesus. And because you're not telling them the truth, you're lying to them. The pastor gonna say today, let me tell y'all why I'm so mad. The pastor said today, Colin Kaepernick, right? I almost got up and walked out of the church as soon as he mentioned it. I said, I can't believe this, right? Trying to relate to his people, right? He's trying to relate to his people. So he said, oh, Colin Kaepernick. He said Colin Kaepernick was kneeling for the flag. Listen, y'all bear with me. Colin Kaepernick was kneeling for the flag, he said, because not because he was against the police, but because he don't want black people to be tried on the corners. So he said that because they're getting killed. You know, they were getting killed by the police when that 1 year or whatever, while Obama was president, might I add. But nobody want to mention that, right? So that anyways, that he don't want black people to be calling Kaepernick kneeled because he don't want black people to be killed in the street. So they was being tried in the street by the police. They was being killed in the street by the police, right? And there the whole congregation jumped up. Not nobody in there under 30, right? Not nobody in there really under 40, 35, under 40, right? Maybe a few. No, I'm sorry. There was a few in there. Maybe like five or six, right? Me and myself included, maybe like five or six, right? But everybody else jump up, raising their head. Yeah, that's right. That's right, Pastor, right?